Today, we'll speak about Facebook Pixel. Don't worry, I know most of you are not developers, I will not push you to some coding, but you will learn how does the Pixel work, and how to instruct your developers to implement it. Hi there, here's Lucas and We Speak Digital. In the previous video, we discussed that to show dynamic ads to people who visited your website, you need to implement the Facebook Pixel. It lets Facebook know who to deliver your ads to based on the actions they've taken, like viewing a specific product or entering payment method. Without this data, your dynamic ads won't be able to make good recommendations to people who are likely to purchase your products. In this video, we'll cover basic steps to implement Facebook Pixel for dynamic ads. First of all, go to your Ads Manager. In top left menu, select Pixels in Measure and Report column. If you haven't done it before, you can create new pixel here. We recommend to use one pixel per website. Definitely, you should make sure that your agency is not using the same pixel for you and other clients they manage. That would screw all the data. Once you have pixel created, you need to implement its call to your website. We recommend to use Google Tag Manager, which will be covered in one of our videos. If you are a marketer, probably it won't be you who is implementing the call to your page, but your developer. Send him or her instructions from Facebook and explain those four steps. Number one, implement the basic code to all pages of your website. Usually this is done by implementing it into head part, which is common for all pages. Step number two, implement view content event for product detail pages. This will ensure that Facebook will receive info about what product was visited. View content should send at least product ID, product price and name. Step number 3 is implement add to cart event. It should be fired once someone adds a product to shopping cart. And again, you want to send to Facebook at least ID of product, which was added, its price and name. And step number 4, implement purchase event to your thank you page. Once a user finishes a purchase, this event should send information about all product bought again, including their price and name. Here you will find very helpful if you implement also product category and brand. With this implementation, you are sending basic info needed to run dynamic ads. But we recommend to go through Facebook's documentation and implement as much as events and parameters possible. This will help you with creating very specific audiences in the future. Thanks for watching and see you all very soon.